Carl, Kelly, and he'll talk about the sandwiched Renyi divergences and how they can be used to quantify strong converse exponent. So please.
So hi, everyone. This talk is based on joint work with my PhD student, Yongsheng Yao. So I will be focusing on the sandwiched Renyi divergence, also known as the minima Renyi divergence. It was introduced 10 years ago in these two papers. And it is defined for usually for two quantum states, rho and sigma, and but more generally, the state sigma can be semi-definitely positive matrix, and there is a real parameter alpha, which is in the intervals from 0 to 1 and from 1 to infinity. We have to be more careful on the range of the parameter alpha, also called the order of the sandwiched Renyi divergence, because actually the sandwiched Renyi divergence behaves well only when the order alpha is in the interval from 1/2 to 1 and from 1 to infinity. This means that in this interval, in this range, the sandwiched Renyi divergence has very nice properties. For example, it satisfies the data processing inequality under the action of quantum channels. It is convex and monotonically decreasing in the state sigma, and it is monotonically increasing in the order alpha. And also the limited cases are very interesting. When the order alpha goes to 1, then the sandwiched Renyi divergence converges to the ordinary quantum relative entropy. When alpha goes to infinity, then it converges to the max relative entropy defined in such a form, and we will be back again to this quantity. When alpha equals 1/2, then it is the mean relative entropy related to the fidelity function. Furthermore, the two intervals from 1/2 to 1 and from 1 to infinity are related by the whole duality. Points in these two intervals are in a one-to-one correspondence governed by the relation here. So we would like to restrict ourselves to the sandwiched Renyi divergence of order alpha in this interval. And the sandwiched Renyi divergence is really a fundamental quantity because it has broader applications. But most importantly, it is because that it admits precise operational interpretations. When the order alpha is bigger than 1, then it has been known much earlier that it characterizes the strong converse exponents for quantum hypothesis testing, for communication over classical quantum channels, for data cooperation with quantum side information, and also More recently, we find that also for entanglement assisted communication of general quantum channels. On the other hand, we also find that it characterizes as well as reliability functions for quantum information decoupling, for quantum channel simulation, and for quantum privacy amplification. The concepts of the strong converse exponents and the reliability functions is to be explained later. But in contrast, when the order alpha is from 1/2 to 1, then for quite a long time, we didn't know any operational interpretations for the sandwiched Renyi divergence. And in this talk, we will provide the first one in this case. Okay, so our answer is that the sandwiched Renyi divergence with order alpha from 1/2 to 1 actually characterizes strong converse exponents for some quantum information processing tasks. They are smoothing of the max relative entropy, quantum privacy amplification, and quantum information decoupling. Before going into the details, let me explain what is the strong converse exponent and what is the reliability function. These two concepts together constitutes the error exponents. Let's consider an asymptotical setting of a general resource theory. There are many copies of a certain kind of the imperfect resource. And we want to transfer them to perfect ones, or we want to prepare them by consuming some perfect resources. Usually there is an optimal rate, R star, denoted by R star here, such that at one side of this value, the error probability of the transformation goes to zero asymptotically, and on the other side, it goes to one. So the error exponents is the exponential rate of this convergence of the error probability towards zero or one. For the case that the error probability goes to zero, then we call it the reliability function, and in the case that the error probability goes to one, then we call it the strong converse exponent. We also need some more entropy quantities. So once we have the sandwiched Renyi divergence, then we can define the induced quantities, the sandwiched Renyi conditional entropy and the sandwiched Renyi mutual information. They are defined for a bipartite quantum state rho AB in a standard way, in standard weights. And here for the conditional entropy, we make optimization over the state on the B system, and for the mutual information, we make a minimization over both quantum states of the A system and the B system. Of course, there are some other way to define the sandwiched Renyi conditional entropy and the mutual information, but these two are the ones that are relevant for our purpose. Okay, so let me go to the quantum information tasks and their strong converse exponents. The first task is smooth self, the max relative entropy. So we have introduced the max relative entropy earlier. The smoothness of this quantity is to try to minimize this quantity by change the state law a little bit within the epsilon ball of this state measured by the, here we employ the purified distance. So this gives us an entropy quantity as a function of the smoothest quantity. We consider its inverse function, the smooth quantity as a function of the entropy quantity. Actually, this smooth quantity is a quantum version of the error probability. And so why do we consider this quantity? Because on the one hand, it is a basic tool in one-shot information theory to along with some other quantities such as the information spectral relative entropy and the hypothesis test relative entropy. And once more, it admits operational meaning in the for characterizing the approximate distinguishability cost. The smooth quantity can be regarded as a quantum version of the error probability. We define the strong converse exponent in the asymptotic city to characterize the speed at which the smooth quantity goes to one exponentially. Here comes our result. We show that the strong converse exponent for smooth self the max relative entropy with respect to the two states rho and sigma is given by a formula in terms of the sandwiched Renyi divergence of water from 1/2 to 1. Let's consider a second quantum task on the quantum privacy amplification. So, suppose that two parties, Alice and Bob, share imperfect private rodness encoded by the rod variable x. It is not maximally mixed, and parts of it information has been linked to adversary stored in a quantum system E. So the way to extract perfect private rodness is by performing a hash function to convert the rod variable x to z. And the performance is quantified by a certain distance of the final stage between the final stage and the ideal stage, which is maximally mixed and with no correlation with the adversary system. Here again, we pick the purified distance as the measure. So we can define, fix the size of the extracted roundness. We can define the optimal performance of the quantum privacy amplification optimized over all possible hash functions. This is again a quantum version of the error probability. So in the asymptotical IDE case, we define the strong converse exponents in such a way, just similar to the first task. We solve the problem of the strong converse exponent in this case, and it's given by with respect to the low key state, low xe is given in this theorem, and it's in terms of the sandwiched conditional entropy with order from 1/2 to 1. The last quantum task we consider is quantum information decoupling. So they consider that there is a bipartite quantum state low RA. Here R is a reference system out of the reach of us. And we can only access the A system. And we wanted to try to remove all the correlations between the R system and the A system. The way to do is by first perform a unitary transformation on the A system and then discard a subsystem A here, here A2. In the catalytic city, we can have another additional and independent system to help us do the work, do the job. this is a primitive quantum information task which has broad applications ranging from quantum Shannon theory itself to quantum thermodynamics and statistical physics and even to black hole physics. We define the strong converse exponent in a similar way. Here, the rate is about the size of the discarded systems, of the discarded system. We fix the size of the discarded system and introduce the optimal performance function optimized over all decoupling strategies. And then in the subtotical city, we define the optimal rate for the error converges to 1. For this problem, our solution for the strong converse exponent is given by is given in terms of the sandwiched Renyi mutual information, but it's a regularized version, and the order is again from 1/2 to 1. We don't know whether the sandwiched Renyi mutual information is additive or not for the tensor product states. If this is the case, then the regularization is not necessary, but we have to leave it open. Okay, then I will talk shortly, quickly on the issue of the quantum generalization of Renyi divergence. In principle, there can be many quantum versions of the classical Renyi divergence due to the non-commutativity of the two quantum states. So to identify what is the correct generalization is significant and not trivial problem. But up to date, there are already two versions of the quantum generalization of the Renyi divergence that have operational interpretations. The first one is the sandwiched Renyi divergence that we have talked about, and the other one is Pate's Renyi divergence defined in such a way. It takes some years to reach the stage of the art understanding of this issue. So in the year 2006, the Pate's Renyi divergence of water from 0 to 1 has been found operational interpretation in characterizing the reliability function. So for a long time, people guess that this quantity is outstanding and it is the unique quantum generalization of Renyi's information divergence. But things changed in 2013 when the sandwiched Renyi divergence has been discovered and shortly operational interpretation for characterizing the strong converse exponents with the order from 1 to infinity has been found. More recently, we found a new type of the operational interpretation for the sandwiched Renyi divergence of order bigger than 1 in characterizing the reliability function. As a main result of this talk, we have found the operational interpretation for the sandwiched Renyi divergence of order from 1/2 to 1. So the last picture is the currently based understanding of this issue. Okay, so let me ask open questions. So the most interesting open question I wanted to ask is what is the final picture of the quantum generalization of the Renyi divergence? I think that the way to give the answer may be to find the error exponents for more quantum information tasks. And I also wanted to ask two more specific and also two smaller questions. First, are there more quantum Renyi divergences, quantum Renyi divergences admitting operational interpretations? We know that there are the geometric Renyi divergence and the non-Euclidean Renyi divergence, which are very useful, but we didn't know any exact operational meaning for them. And second, we noticed that the Pate Renyi divergence of water from 1 to 2 admits very nice properties, and we conjecture that it has exact operational interpretation for this case, in this case, and we leave it as an open question. Okay, thank you.
No questions yet. I mean, maybe I can ask one then. So you mentioned, maybe I missed it, but for this decoupling, uh-huh. You had a regularization, and it was not clear if it's needed or not, or? So you said this is needed, or is open if it's needed?
Sorry. Can you
So here you have this regularized quantity, right?
Yeah.
Do you need the regularization?
We don't know whether it's necessary or not.
Do you have a conjecture?
I don't know.
I see.
Yeah, I have no idea. I don't know.
But what is different from, let's say, the privacy amplification? Like, why do you don't need regularization, and here you might need it?
For what case?
So you had this previous example, right, on privacy amplification. And there you had like a conditional entropy function there, right, instead of a mutual information. Like your theorem 2.
Yeah. For the other two problems, yes, there's no, there's a singulator solution. There's no,
yes,
regularization here, and also, because these guys are additive for test product states.
Yes, so the conditional entropy is additive, but for the mutual informations, it's not clear. Okay, I see.
Because of the definition, it depends on the definition of these quantities, because here we define,
yes,
the self-iterating mutual information with the minimization over two quantum states. If it's only for one, then it's additive, shown by, I think, yeah, by Marco and the co-authors.
Yeah, this seems like an interesting question, yeah? Okay, thanks. Any last questions from Carl? Yes.
Thanks for the nice talk. I was just wondering if any of these things extend to channels?
This is a good question. Currently, there's no results on channels yet. But a really nice question, yes.
Thanks.
Okay, perfect. So let's thank Carl again.